Hello and welcome to episode number 8 of Eliphas Leary Lectures About Magic. This time I'm going to talk about the Qabbalah and the letters used in the Hebrew Qabbalah. Those letters are, as everybody knows, written from the right to the left. The right side is heaven, left side is the earth. And they are written between two lines. The upper line is the heaven and the bottom line is the earth. The first letter, well, it's called the first letter, it's actually not the first letter in the Hebrew alphabet. The first letter is the Yud. Yud is the first letter because you make it when you touch the paper with a pen. And also, it's the first letter you produce when you make any of those letters. Each letter starts with a Yud. This is most obvious in the letter Vav. The Vav is a Yud with a little line that touches the earth. In other letters like the Resh, you see a big Yud, a giant Yud. Or the letter Beth, it is a Resh with a little line at the bottom, a little line on the earth. A different letter is the Daleth. It's a long line in the heaven and a little hook and a line that goes down to the earth. Most obvious, this Yud as starting point of all the letters is in the letter Shin. There we have three Yuds and they are connected by a line at the earth. Or let's look at the letter Aleph. The Aleph has two Yuds, one in the heaven, one on the earth, and between them there's a line. This line is sometimes referred to as a daleth, a pathway, a door. And this door is the gateway for the Yod to come from the heaven to the earth. And the Aleph can also be imagined as a whirling thing, a whirling letter, spinning around. But now let's have a look at the letters as paths of the Yod. First of all, let's take the letter Samech. In the Samech, the Yod goes to the sky, then down to the earth, and up again to the sky. Kind of the opposite to the Samech is the letter Teth. It goes straight down to the earth, then goes a bit on the earth, and goes back to the sky again. Or the letter Mem. It goes straight to the ground and then bounces up to the sky again to come in a whirling way down to the earth again. Now let's have a little look at the numbers in the connection to the letters. First of all, let's have a look at the name Aya. Aya means I will be, and its number is 21. Well, we have 22 letters in the Hebrew alphabet. One of them is the Yud, and the other 21 letters are the paths of the Yud. And when you consider the fact that we have 5 capital letters in the Hebrew alphabet, well, let's look at the name Yahweh. Yahweh adds to the number 26. And again, with the 5 capital letters, we have 27 letters. One of them is the Yud, and the other 26 letters are the paths of the Yud. We can combine the two names, Eya and Yahweh, to a hexagrammaton called Eyahweh. This name, well, it's not actually a name of God, but it's a nice formula. This name adds to the number 32. And 32 is the number of the Sephirot and the Paths in the Qabbalah. So, you might get the idea. The names of God, or the formulas connected to them, explain a lot about things. Well, Aleister Crowley used the Qabbalah to prove some things in his mysticism. And the Qabbalah is a quite good means to do that. Well, you can exaggerate that, but you can exaggerate everything. I hope you enjoyed this little episode, and I hope I showed you something that you didn't consider yet. And until next time, see you soon.